Hi, this is Scott Garibay, and today I'm going to be talking specifically about the Garibay blockbuster law, Homage. Garibay BLaw, Homage. All right, so let's get into this. This is a movie topic, and this is a blockbuster law, a BLaw, made by me, J. Scott Garibay. All right, and it is the Garibay BLaw Homage, right? And so what it is here is the law itself. Go with blessing all those who homage a movie that is 20 years or older. That's the Garibay BLaw Homage. All right, so what does that mean exactly? Well, what that means is that if you homage a film, some people would use the word knock off, right? I believe those two things are synonymous. It's the same thing just being said by two different people, right? Homage would be used by the creator, and then knock off would be an experiencer who's not really happy about something being homaged, all right? So at that point, I'm saying that it is perfectly fine to homage any movie that's 20 years or older, okay? And by extension, curses on those who homage a film that is not 20 years or older, okay? So that's the line. Now, why are we talking about Garibay BLaw Homage today? Well, the reason why is the movie Skyscraper, which is an exciting new film coming out this year in 2018 by Dwayne The Rock Johnson, all right? And that movie came out, it was actually had a Super Bowl commercial. Yeah, that's expensive, man. You know, like Super Bowl commercial the rate was $5 million for 30 seconds. So they paid millions and millions and millions of dollars to get this the Skyscraper commercial on there. I think there might have even been more than one skyscraper commercial during the Super Bowl. So yeah, it was a big launch. They invested a lot of money, and they're saying, hey, this is an important new film that's coming out. Well, the moment it came out on the Super Bowl, Twitter lighted up, and the internet, you know, then carried the message that people were saying, hey, this is a Die Hard knockoff. You can't do that. This is just a bad Die Hard knockoff, right? And or actually, they were just saying, this is a Die Hard knockoff. And people really, you know, being upset about that, just saying, oh, that's just Die Hard, right? Well, the reality is, okay, Die Hard was made in 1988. 1988. That is literally 30 years ago, right? Now, we live in 2018, man. These are times where things turn on a dime. The pace of change has never, ever been faster. 30 years is three lifetimes today. It's just so long, right? So the reality is, I do think that that Skyscraper is an homage, not a knockoff, to Die Hard. It's using almost all the same themes, but I think that's perfectly acceptable. One, when you do an homage, you have to put something unique and new into that film, right? And there is something unique and new in this film. Dwayne The Rock Johnson's character has a amputated, there's an amputation on his leg. So he's missing, I believe it's his left foot. So he is missing his left foot, okay? So at that point, he has a prosthetic. That's the word I wanted to use, a prosthetic, okay? So he has a prosthetic leg. It actually has a prosthetic foot specifically, okay? He has a prosthetic foot. It's actually cut off like about halfway through the calf, it looks like, right? So he is going through all the same motions as John McClane, but he has a prosthetic foot, right? Now to me, that's all you need to make this movie an homage, right? It means that it is fundamentally different than Die Hard. Now, how does having a prosthetic leg make that movie fundamentally different, right? Well, it makes it fundamentally different in two different ways, right? One, it absolutely will make the movie fundamentally different. It'll be two. It's all in how they handle How do they handle this prosthetic leg, right? So if they show that this prosthetic leg is a huge hindrance to him getting his goals done, or even that he has limitations and that he's not able to do the same things that John McClane was able to do because he doesn't have 2 feet, right? Then his character has an incredibly different journey than John McClane's character, right? And that makes the movie different. But let's say that the prosthetic leg is on there, and really, he does all the same things as John McClane, right? Then the movie is making a statement, and the statement is, oh, well, you might have a physical challenge, you might have a prosthetic leg, but you can do everything an action hero can do. That is a message that that Die Hard did not carry, right? And which means that the movie, no matter how it handles the prosthetic leg, it is fundamentally different. It has an element that was not contained within Die Hard, okay, even though all the other elements are pretty much the same, right? Right. So family stuck in a high building that's literally owned by a Japanese corporation. Like, there's a lot of similarities between Skyscraper and Die Hard. But to me, you can absolutely reskin Die Hard as long as you put in a unique element and move forward. I think that's perfectly acceptable, you know, and the reality is, I just think it's really important that people understand you can own your movie. You can own Die Hard, but you cannot own, you know, a modern actioner, because that's all that's really being done here is you're just making another modern actioner. Now, it might look a lot like, you know, Die Hard, and the reason why is Die Hard was the very best there was ever at a modern actioner, right? So I think that's the issue there. So I heard a lot of people, you know, hem and haw about Skyscraper saying, this is just a Die Hard knockoff. To me, go with blessings. And the Garibay BLaw homage says it's perfectly okay to do this, and I think it's fine. Now, I also want to address real quickly that a lot of people are saying, this is really bad for the industry because Hollywood makes a lot of remakes, right? And they make a lot of remakes, and there's nothing new at the theater, right? Well, that's just not true, right? There are a lot of remakes. There are a lot of reboots. There are a lot of prequels. There are a lot of series. There are a lot of comic book movies. There are big trends within Hollywood, right? But Hollywood is absolutely not done making fresh new properties, right? And we own a good bit of this. One of the and so I'll throw some out. Get Out and Monster Trucks from 2017. Those were two brand new, absolutely brand new movies that had never existed, right? And that's important, right? So, and there were many, many others, at least 10 other really unique properties that were brand new, films that had never really been made before, about topics that had never really been touched in film before. So there really are a lot of new movies. So I think it's perfectly fine to homage these old movies because there are fantastic new movies that are coming out. Now, one of the things is people were very responsive to Get Out last year, and that did tremendously well, right? But people were not responsive to Monster Trucks. So that's another. I loved Monster Trucks. It was one of my. It's in my top 10 of films for 2017, right? But almost nobody went to see that movie, and there was a hard rejection of it. So when you see homages being done again, we own that, because when people make cool new movies like Monster Trucks, people don't go see them, right? And so if we truly want to see less homages and more original content, we need to start giving these films, these other types of films, more commercial support, right? So, but overall, I say go with, you know, the Garibay BLaw homage says, go with blessings, those who are homaging a film that is 20 years or older. And that's Garibay BLaw homage. Take care.